Okay, this is 1.3 strategies for problem solving. Here is Polya's four-step method for problem solving. So he says to understand the problem, which might mean rereading the problem and asking yourself, what it is you need to find. Then making a plan, so that might be making a drawing or make an equation. Making a table, whatever it is, make your plan, carry out that plan, look back and check. Sometimes the answer you get doesn't really make sense to the question. So here are some strategies that you can use. Look for a pattern, draw a sketch, use inductive reasoning, trial and error, common sense, look for a catch, work backward. So, for example, in the sequence 16, 80, 48, 64, A, B, C, D, each term beyond the second term is an arithmetic mean or average of the previous terms. We need to find what D is. Well, in order to get A, A must be the average of 48 and 64. So to get an average, you add numbers up and divide by 2. So if you do that with these, you get 56, which means that B would be 64 plus 56 divided by 2, which is 60. And C would be 56 plus 60 divided by 2, which is 58. And finally, we get to D, which is 60 plus 58 over 2, and that is 59. Okay. Alright, Cindy was asked by her teacher to subtract 3 from a certain number, so we let our certain number be x, subtract 3, and divide by 9, but instead she subtracted 9 and then divided by 3. And she ended up getting 43. What would her answer have been if she had worked the problem correctly? Well, if we multiply both sides of this equation by 3 to get rid of the fraction, then we would get x minus 9 equals 129. And then to get x by itself, you want to add 9 to both sides. So x is 138. So she took the number, subtracted 9, and then divided by 3. So the number that she was given must have been 138. So if she would have done what she was supposed to with 138, which was subtract 3 and then divide by 9, well, that would be 135 over 9, which is 15. So this is what she should have got. Algebra probably wasn't the only way to tackle this. So you could use your imagination, or not your imagination, but think outside the box, and you might be able to figure this out by working backwards or just trial and error. You don't have to do it the way I've done it, as long as you're getting the right answer. At his birthday party, Mr. Green would not directly tell how old he was. He said, if you add the year of my birth to this year, subtract the year of my 10th birthday, and the year of my 50th birthday, then add my present age, the result is 80. How old was Mr. Green? Okay, what I would like you to do with this one is to, for extra credit, post not only your answer, and more importantly, I'm looking for how you got it. So post your solution up on Blackboard And if I like it, I'll give you some extra credit. I want to see you use your thinking outside the box talents for that one. All right, number six. You're playing tic-tac-toe, but this is a backwards tic-tac-toe where if you get three in a row, you lose. So in other words, you don't want to get three in a row, and you are O. So it's asking, what should your next move be if you want to, like, being guaranteed to win? So if we put, let's try some things. Say we put an O here. Well, then X could go here, and you could go here, and then X could go here. That might just work, right? Because X is also trying to win. And trying to think of a scenario. So if you went there, so what are some other options here? I'm going to delete these. So you go there. X also doesn't want three in a row, so they're probably not going to go here because they want you to be forced to go there. They might go here. Oops. Go away. Delete. Yes. They might go. Oh, I gotta get my tooling again. Okay. They could go there, which would be a problem because then you'd be forced to go here or here. And either way, you would lose. So that doesn't work. That will not guarantee that you win. All right, let's try. This is one where you just use trial and error. So let's see what happens if I go here. This might be a little safer. If I go here, then I have too many, I have, you know, two ways that I could lose. Here, there's only one possible. If I have to be forced to go here, then I would lose. So let's see what X is going to do. X is not going to go here because, I'll just put it in here. They don't want to go there because that would make them lose. So they're probably going to go here. And in your next move, you would not go there because you would lose. You might want to go there. And then X would go here. But that wouldn't make you win. It would just make you not lose. It's not forcing X to have to lose. So let's try another scenario. Let's go here. On X's next move, they might go here because here is definitely bad for them. And here is not terrible, but not good either. So then your next move, you would go here. And that would force them to go here. And they would lose and you would win. The only other scenario with that is, let me get rid of all these. Instead of going there, they would go here. But you would still go here and they would be forced to go here. So, in other words, this is where you want to go to make sure that you win. Number seven is, is a doozy. It's another one. I'm going to say extra credit. For the right answer, email me. Now, privately, email me the answer if you think you got it. Be very careful with that. Right? It says rectangle, okay? So squares are rectangles. And I had to draw this myself, so there's a little gape in here, but pretend that that gape isn't there. Number eight, we need to know what the unit digit is in 3 to the 324th power. So this is equal to some number, and really all we care about is this last digit. Now if you try to put that in your calculator, it's probably going to give you an error. So we have to devise some other plan to find what that unit digit would be. Well, I don't know what else to try other than just looking at what happens when, you know, you raise 3 to different powers. So 3 to the 0 is 1, 3 to the 1st is 3, 3 squared is 9, 3 cubed is 27, 3 to the 4th is 81, 3 to the 5th is 243, 3 to the 6th is 729, 3 to the 7th is 2187. Now wait a minute, I'm seeing a pattern here. Do you see a pattern? I see that it's going 1, 3, 9, 7, 1, 3, 9, 7. Now remember, I'm only looking at the unit digit, because that's what I'm asked to find. So it does this pattern and it repeats every fourth time. So this would be 3 to the 0, 3 to the 1st, 3 squared, 3 to the 3rd, and this would be to the 4th, and the 5th, the 6th, the 7th, and so on. So I know 3 to the 8th now would, that's where it starts over again, that would be a 1. And if I skip down a couple and I wanted to know 3 to the 12th power, I would know that's a 1. I would know 3 to the 10th is a 9. So I think you can sort of see where I'm going with this now. So if we look at, you know, where we look at the number 324, what we need to know is where that number falls in the pattern. Well, you might notice that, for example, where it's a 1, we've got 4 and 8 and 12. These are all multiples of 4. And lo and behold, if you divide 324 by 4, since it's repeating every fourth one, this is actually, it's 81. Not that we don't really care, you know, what the answer is. What we care about is that it goes unevenly. So in other words, 324 is going to be way out here somewhere, you know, way past what we've got so far. But it's going to be a multiple of 4, so the units digit is going to have to be a 1. And it might help you, if you're confused, to go out even further than I did, and you can see that the pattern repeats. Actually, let me add one thing to here. Say I asked you for the 325th, 3 to the 325th power. Well, that would be one, well, not equals, but the ones digit would be one past something that goes into 4 evenly, so it would be 3. Because 4 is 1, you look over to the next one, this would be one past that. The answer, it would, the units digit would be a 3. Okay. All right, that's it for 1.3.